I'm going to try to do a real speedy demonstration about color here. Now, this is cadmium red medium. So that gives me one of the interesting things about physics, that we can arrange the colors into a wheel, and it's all based upon the vibrations of electromagnetic light. And what we see is that when colors are directly across from one another, they are as far away from each other as possible, and we call those complementary colors. If they're right next to each other, they're analogous colors. So there is this kind of scientific rhythm to the nature of color, and the color wheel that I showed you, gave you the example of, shows us also that there are chords, very much like the chords in music. For example, if we put an exact triangle in here, we have a triadic harmony. If we take any two sets of complements, we get a tetradic harmony. One of my favorite harmonies is a split complement where, for instance, red and green are complementary, but red, blue-green and yellow-green is a split complement. So that's a very sort of exciting kind of combination of colors. There's a lot of sort of brassy sound to that almost. But these, so the color wheel, now how do we use this in our actual paintings? Most of the time we're looking at something in nature and we're just trying to get that color. But often in a painting, we have to come up with a color for, like for instance, a wall behind a head or something like that. And that's where our knowledge of the color wheel and these different harmonies can come into play. So that's a real quick tour of the color wheel. Of course, if we take a color, I'll take this, some cadmium red here. So there's a color wheel, there are our complementary scale, a saturation scale, the color to a neutral gray, a tint scale, the color to white, and a value scale, the color to black. Now, I want to show you another thing that most people don't really understand, and that is the difference between a hue color and a pure color. Now, if I get a brand new brush for this, this is cerulean blue hue. Cerulean blue hue. And this is pure cerulean blue. And you might say, well, they look pretty much identical, and the cerulean blue hue is made from petrochemicals. The cerulean blue, the pure, is made from minerals. Now, where we see a difference is when we mix white in with those colors. Now, there's cerulean blue hue. Now I'm going to mix some white in with pure cerulean. I don't know if this is even going to show up on our videos here. I can see it very clearly looking at it here. But the primary difference between those two colors is that when I add white to this pure cerulean, there's a slight gray cast to the tint scale. When I add white to cerulean blue hue, I don't get that graying quality. Now, is one thing better than the other? It depends what you're trying to do. If you're trying to create depth and space, that graying quality actually helps you create the sense of depth. And that's why I like to use pure cerulean blue to make things go back in space, and I'm going to demonstrate that shortly. If you want a more lively kind of color sense and you want to keep bright, strong colors, maybe it's someone's wearing a bright blue shirt or something like that and you want it to seem real lively, well, I'd stay away from any of the pure colors and use the hues. Cadmium red hue, cadmium orange hue, things like that, cerulean blue, cobalt blue hue. They're all going to tend to be brighter and stronger, and you won't get that graying effect. Just real quickly here, I have examples. Let's see how it works. Here's cobalt blue hue, and then this one is pure cobalt blue. Now I'll add some white to those. I may edit this out of the video, we'll see. Now take some white. Wiping out the brush, rinsing it out in my water thinner. It's very subtle, but you may be able to see. A couple other little side notes here about color. I think I like to use certain really sort of unusual colors because, you know, you look at the paint charts of the colors that are available and they're so luscious looking, you want them all. And most of them you can do without. But there are certain colors you just simply cannot make. You have to buy them. This is something called Brilliant Pink, and it is kind of a very vibrant pink. This is a whole bean product, Brilliant Pink. It's really a beautiful pink that I just see when you start adding white to reds, it becomes this pale pink. But this pink, Brilliant Pink, it is very intense in its color. So, you know, all I can tell you about, here's another one that I've been relying upon a lot. Cobalt Turquoise. There is just no way to make this color from any blues and yellows. You cannot make this color any other way. You have to buy it. Cobalt Turquoise, really interesting blue color. And of course, the strongest colors are the cadmium colors, and I love cadmium green, another very color that just you can get close to this with yellows and blues, but and say sap green with some yellow in it, but you can't quite get that leafy, springy green any other place except through cadmium green. So those are some examples of things you can do with color and the difference between hue and pure colors.